Well, we're talking about Brownie.
We're talking about Brownie. You're obviously not listening.
Brownie! Brownie, Brownie, Brownie! Wake your tail, Brownie.
Brownie.
Come here. Come here. Come here, Brownie. Ooh! What makes you think you could get up on the couch, huh? Huh? Stick your nose up here in the camera. Come here. Come on. Come on. Come on. Let me see your nose.
Stop rubbing her and she'll look up.
Brownie.
I saw a stick
to
her nose.
Ah, there you go, pretty puppy. Sit, sit, sit. Sit. Say hi. You're so silly. Here we go. Close up of Brownie. Beautiful puppy.
This
beautiful.
Okay.
Let's stop.
Hello, Brownie. Brownie. Smile, Brownie. You're on video. Yes. You're a cute little puppy. Yeah. Hello everyone, Gilda Blaze here along with my dog Brownie. And today we will be continuing the series I've been doing about wacky and bizarre holidays of 2011 and other years. Now today is March 3rd, and on March 3rd... Oh fine, lay down out of the camera. Which is... Take the piece of ham I'm holding. You want this, don't you, Brownie? Get in the camera, Brownie. Brownie? She would totally grab this piece of meat if she had opposable thumbs. Instead, she just sits here patiently waiting for me to give her the meat. Good girl. Thanks for helping me with my video, doll. If dogs had opposable thumbs, they would probably go and open up the front door as well and let themselves out for a walk. I guess that would be a good thing, the fact that you wouldn't have to go and follow them and pick up certain things they leave behind. However, they probably wouldn't come back, which would be a bad thing. Now, meanwhile, if cats had opposable thumbs, that would probably be a fairly bad thing, as the cats would go and probably go and create some sort of like declaration of independence for cats, rebel against the human world, do things such as asking for cheeseburgers, and... What? You're good, okay? Jeez. Anyways, they would do such things as asking for cheeseburgers, grab machine guns and start firing them, or just rebel against the human race for using them in so many memes. Yes. Yes, yes. My dog just loves having attention on her. Yes. Yes, you're a good dog. Anyways, there's not much else I can say about this one, except that's probably what I theorized what cats and dogs would do if they had opposable thumbs. And so, thank you for tuning in. Join me next time on March 26th for Make Up Your Own Holiday Day, which I'm quite looking forward to. Say goodbye to the people, Brownie. Brownie, say goodbye to the people. Say goodbye to the people. Brownie, say goodbye to the... Ah, forget it. Anyways, this is Gilda Blaze. Holiday number 9, which is more of a... Hello everyone, Gilda Blaze here, and welcome back to my series of bizarre and wacky holidays of 2011 and other years. Now, on June 24th is holiday number 11 of my bizarre and wacky holidays list. And it is also the reason I am filming my dog. For on June 24th, it is Take Your Dog to Work Day.
Brownie, come on, look at the camera. Yes, you're a cute little dog, aren't you? Admit it, you find her to be extremely cute. Right, Brownie? Right, you're cute. Come here. Come here. Come. You lazy, spoiled dog. Oh, well, she's cute.
She's too close.
Oh, hi. She's not.
She's not noticing?
No, she's noticing.
Wait, let's see. Brownie, popcorn.
No. She's too far away.
Brownie, back up, back up.
It's one of those once-in-a-lifetime things. Hey there, Samantha.
Samantha.
It was a once-in-a-lifetime thing. She did eventually eat it.
Why don't
you just pepper her with popcorn?
No.
Brownie.
Are you going to try to put this on
YouTube? Only if it works.
You gotta get it right there too.
You have to get in that spot where it, like... Yeah, I have to get in that spot where it doesn't fall.
You're going to Hollywood. That makes it so obvious!
It wouldn't stay. Yeah. Wait, this, no, she's distracted, Samantha. Do it, do it, do it, do it. Brownie! There. She doesn't notice.
Can you get mad at me for telling the dog with popcorn?
Look at John!
It's still there.
Poor baby.
We are such cool people.
Oh, there we go. Alright.
She's sort of moving her head around just like, wait, there's something on my head. Yeah, we're sorry we're so cool. But it's funny to watch you.
Well, we got you to play with.
I thought we got
her
because she was cute.
That too. Yo, here's a piece of popcorn.
Alright.
We spoil you enough. Okay. Hi, Brownie.
Brownie, Brunilla, Buzzbutt.
All the different names we used to call her, yeah. Can you wag your tail, Brownie? Brownie? Can you wag your tail? Brownie?
Yeah. Yeah.
Wake your tail, Brownie. Wake your tail.
Are you wagging her tail? I mean, something's coming. Who's giving me something? Yeah.
I wouldn't miss her. I'm going to miss her.
I miss her very much, Sean. It's a big part of our life.
Oh. Fuzziness. Always had that one little line of fur that stuck up between her eyes. Mm-hmm. Her little flappy ears. Her cute little paws. Those eyes of hers. And that tail.
Mm-hmm.
That tail that would be all little scorpion like when she put it up the hallway. No, it was like her tail would stick straight up in the hair and the hair hung off, so it looked like a little scorpion pose.
Mm-hmm. Yes, I suppose it did. I didn't think of it that way.
I did. It also doubled her height.
Yeah, that's double the amount of fur on her body.
She... her size doubled with her fur.
Mm-hmm.
I'm gonna miss you. Everyone's gonna miss you. Goodbye, Brownie. Sorry about that. Goodbye. Yeah. 3 minutes, that's good enough.
Mm-hmm.